like you for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my king. I wanna be.
Yes, sir. We'll bow down and say you are God. We'll bow down and say. God, it's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time to give him the praise and the honor that is due unto his mighty name. Today I must take this opportunity to greet each and everyone in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God. God is a good God and he is worthy to be praised. Greeting our assistant pastor, Elder Dwight Reid, in the mighty name of Jesus. Greeting Elder William Force, praise God. Minister William Force, Evangelist Reid, Evangelist Wright, praise God. Deacon Williams, Deaconess Morrison, hallelujah. Praise God. Musician, praise team. Praise God. God is a good God. And we just want to welcome each and every one to our Missionary Sunday. Praise the name of Jesus. This is the final Missionary Sunday for 2020. And to God be the glory. Great things he has done. Praise God. We would be here today, but God has been good. He has been favorable unto us, and today we just give him the glory and the praise that is due unto his mighty name. Praise God. I want to take this opportunity to greet my pastor and overseer Gwendolyn Reid in the mighty name of Jesus. God is a good God to us. Hallelujah. She is still here. Hallelujah. The devil is vexed, but we are glad she here. So God be the glory, great things he has done. The devil had another plan, but Jesus had a bigger plan for her. Praise the name of Jesus. And the work is not yet accomplished, so the devil cannot do away with her. Hallelujah. As he sees it, praise the name of Jesus. She will not leave an unfinished task in the name of Jesus. Just continue to pray her strength in the Lord as you continue to go from day to day. Praise the name of Jesus. If you have your Bibles with me, just stand and turn with me to 1 John chapter 1. Praise God. Hallelujah. 1 John chapter 1 from verse 1 to the end. Hallelujah, Jesus. Please stand, everybody, everywhere. Thank you, Lord. And it begins thus. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled of the word of life. For the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. That which we have seen and heard declare we unto you, that he also have fellowship with us, and surely our fellowship is with the Father, and with his Son, Jesus Christ. And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. This then is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him, and walk in darkness, we lie, and do not the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 10th and last. If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and the word is not in us. This is the word of the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Can you praise the Lord, everybody? Can you praise the Lord, everybody? Praise the name of Jesus. God is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, Jesus. We are here to worship God, and worship God we must. Amen, somebody? Praise God. Some of us were not in church for a few weeks, but God is still keeping us. He is still delivering. He is still blessing. Praise the name of us. Praise the name of Jesus, somebody. Praise the name of Jesus, somebody. Come on, shout hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. When I look over this church, praise the name of Jesus. Some of us have been through some hard struggles, but we are still here. We are still breathing. We have life in our body. Hallelujah. We can lift our hands and praise Him. We can clap our hands and praise Him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Though we have been through struggles, some of us, we are still blessed. Praise the name of Jesus. Some people might lose their job, but saints of God, we are still here. We have not run for our best hungry. We can still find food. Hallelujah, Jesus. The Bible said, what a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah, Jesus. And to God be the glory, great things He hath done. Praise God. So let us worship Him, somebody. Let us worship Him. Somebody say, when the praises go up, then the blessing comes on. Hallelujah. Many of the people have stayed home like others, but we come to the house of God and just let us worship Him. Don't look at the person next to you. Don't pay attention to the empty seats. Just worship God. Just give Him praise. Praise Him for somebody who's not here. Praise Him for those who are coming on the way. Hallelujah, Jesus. Why won't you lift up your hands and praise the Lord? Praise Him for His goodness. Praise Him for His
love. Thank you.
testimony. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise Him.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God. Hallelujah, bless Jesus. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Praise Him.
Hallelujah.
Praise Him.
With each and every one, you know, somebody. You know what I'm glad about? Touching down to the end of the year, I'm still here. I'm not out. You know, I'm still amongst the living in the house of God. Still giving thanks and prayers. You know, it could be worse, but God kept me through. You know, for God is the starter and He is the finisher. So from start of her, He must finish it. So I have to give God thanks and praise in Jesus' name.
Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus. Sister Williams.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Him.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
I just want to thank God today. I know that I am blessed. Every day of my life, as long as I have life, I am blessed. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise Him.
God has been such a good God to me. I could have been otherwise minded. But glory be to God, I am still here. I still have life. I am not among the dead, but I am among the brethren in the land of the living. Praise God, everybody. So many things has happened for the past few weeks. Hallelujah. We had to stay home. We had to be in quarantine. Hallelujah, Jesus. But it's because the mercy of God. Hallelujah. The Bible said when He sees the blood, He will pass over. Hallelujah. I don't know about you this morning, but I have heaven on my mind. Hallelujah, Jesus. I said I have heaven on my mind. And I just want to sing this verse, a song this morning. Hallelujah. I'm too near to my home, too near to my heavenly home. I can't turn back again. I made my run. There is nothing worthwhile to look about now. Praise the Lord.
Come on, hallelujah.
Jesus.
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 When she came back from the hospital, it's like God renew our strength. Mm-hmm. I am here to tell somebody today, the doctor gives medication, but God gives healing. Before she went to the hospital, you have to help her to ease up off of the bed that she cried for pain. And the sense of God, she put over her foot like this without anybody else, and she bring up her sick without anybody else. Who could it be?
Hallelujah. He's always looking out for me. Thank you. Praise God, I was watching Bethel United Church of Jesus Christ, Soul Control, and I heard this song. And I grabbed my book same time and I just started writing out the song. And it ministers to me so much because God is always looking out for us. Even his opening words, we can't even see the door. Praise the name of Jesus, but he's always busy looking out for his children. Praise the name of Jesus. And so I just write out the song as I was singing at church one Sunday. Praise the name of Jesus. To God be the glory, great things yet done. Praise God. Today I also want to invite Elder Dwight to come and to greet us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shall
we praise the Lord, everyone?
Shall
we praise the Lord, everybody? This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. If you're happy and you know it, say amen. Young people, if you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, shout hallelujah. Praise be to God. Come on, give God a hand. God is so good. God is so good. It is true. He is good all the time. And I give honor and glory to the Spirit of God in the house here this afternoon. So glad that God was able to take us from far and near and to help us to congregate together into this house of worship. Praise the Lord. Even in the days of pandemic, we are still finding time to worship our God. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. And I'm glad that we are here today in this worship service to give honor to the Spirit of God. Amen. I want to use the opportunity again to also extend a greeting and welcome to those that are viewing us online on our various platforms. Amen. God bless you for where you're viewing us from. We appreciate your joining us this Sunday morning, and may you continue to be blessed in the presence of the Lord. Amen. You know that this has been a very eventful week for us. So many things we want to give God thanks for. Praise God. You heard Sister Norma's testimony as it concerns our pastor. You know, I was not able to visit her earlier last week, and so the very first chance I got to visit her while she was in the hospital was on Wednesday. Amen. Wednesday. And as the story goes, I try to get information from the medical team, what's the position and what is happening and what is likely to happen. The young doctor came and said to me, you know, we might let her out today. And I said, what, doctor? And I wasn't sure if I wanted to be happy or surprised. But maybe I was two of them. Yes, they did her a check on her, you know, vital signs. You know, the various gadgets, they have some things that stick onto your finger, some things that wrap on your head and all kind of things. And based on what they said, she said that she was doing fine. Praise God. So I said, I leaned over to oversee and said, Mom, they don't want to send you home today. And then all of a sudden I did bright. And she said, what you say? Mom, they want to send you home today. And she said, who tell you that? The doctor? And I said, yes, Mom, yes. She was very happy to get out of the place. I tell you, praise God. Amen. You know, sometimes God gives us a surprise answer, doesn't he? Yes. Mighty God of Daniel. We're here praying for a long time and asking God to do some stuff for us. And then when it happens, we are there wondering. Yeah, it happens to all of us. Shall we praise the Lord? Praise God. You know, sometimes God works in his own time. And we can't dictate to God when to do something, but sometimes he works really fast. Blessed be to God. And so I'm happy that she's home. I know you're happy. Praise be to God that overseer is home. And from my observation, she is on the continual improve. Amen. So don't stop praying. Shall we praise God? You know God works. Sometimes he does an instantaneous thing, but sometimes it takes it through a process. So many times when we are going through the process, we start to get lazy and start praying. But let us not get lazy. Amen. The Bible says to pray without ceasing, that we can move the bonds of the enemy. Shall we praise God? Prayer can break chain. Hallelujah. So we're not going to stop praying. The devil wants us to stop, but we're not going to stop. We're too smart for that. Continue to pray for her. Amen. That you know, God will take her through. Because there's many more ministry left in that life. Shall we praise God? Shall we praise God? Amen. Even when she was in hospital, she was there ministering against my advice. Yeah, but you know, she was finding something to do, to testify to somebody, to pray for somebody, to make a difference in the world. Shall we praise God? Don't you know what kind of situation God put you in? You are there for a reason. Shall we praise God? You remember when they put Daniel in prison, he was there for a reason. Praise God. He was there for a reason, and sometimes we won't understand until we are gone through. God bless you. She's there. She's doing well. I'm continue to pray for God's help for her. And praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. I want to talk about some other stuff, because some person celebrated birthday over the week, and we want to celebrate with missionary Patricia Malav. Amen. She celebrated on the 30th. Amen. Praise God. Come on, give her a hand. And would you know, in the midst of our celebration, shows up by the hospital visiting pastor. Give her a bigger hand. Praise be to God. Yes. We want to celebrate also on December 1st with Sister Sharoni Givens. Lord bless you, Sister Sharoni. Happy birthday to you. And also on the 1st of the day, we have Brother Christopher Smart. He's celebrated on the 1st of December. Amen. And just yesterday, Brother Chaswick Ross celebrated his birthday. Come on, give a greater hand. Amen. God bless all of these persons who were born. And we appreciate you for being a part of us. In Jesus' name. I had forgotten last week when I came to the podium to let you know that, you know, Minister Malav is back with us. Praise the Lord. Shall we praise the Lord for this year? Praise God. I want to remind you all that tomorrow is prayer meeting online. Don't forget to be a part of that. Shall we praise the Lord? Amen. Are you looking for prayer meeting? Come on, let me see your hand here. I know some of you are having difficulties in connecting, but see, we can work that one out, right? Because it is very important that we be a part of this prayer meeting. It's been a blessing to so many persons, and it has a way of bringing people together from all over, converting at one point. And it's not just a prayer, but fellowship. Amen. So tomorrow, Monday, 6:30 p.m., don't miss that. Also remember, we have Tuesday fasting here. This is in person now, in church, 10 a.m. Don't miss that as well. And Wednesday, online again, we have our midday meditation and prayer. Wednesday, midday. I'm going to ask you please to make sure that you view the broadcast. Always remember to share. Always remember to like, to comment, and to what else? Subscribe. Yes. Right. I need to remember all of that. You know, I should get it rolling off my tongue. What else? You know, right there. Praise the Lord. So that's Wednesday, and of course, you know, we have our broadcast on Sundays at 11 a.m. Don't let any of this miss you. I mean, it's part of the ministry. You're a part of the ministry. And so we are going to be we are going to contribute. God bless you in Jesus' name. I have one last thing to do before I leave. I have new equipment for the Lord. Shall we praise the Lord? Amen. God, everybody could be that minister. Every time he goes away, he brings back something. Praise God. God bless him. God bless him. And so we have a new microphone in our midst right now. And we're going to be asking God's blessing on it. Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we praise the Lord? Minister, I want to specifically call the name of the person who assisted you. Can you give him the name again? James Roger. Okay. All right. James Roger. Remember that name. We're going to pray now that God will bless him and save him in the name of Jesus. Please bow your heads with me, everybody, as we bless this equipment. Lord, thank you again for this wonderful equipment, Lord, that your son has donated again to the ministry. Lord, as he continues to give, we pray, Lord, that you will continue to bless him and to make ways, even where there appear to be no way, Lord. Open up windows for him and continue to bless your son in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, that you will bless his boss, James, who was able to instrumentally get this thing together that we can be benefiting from it. Lord God, we pray, Lord, that in his giving, that you'll cause his business to be successful in the name of Jesus. Oh God, that he will, hallelujah, somehow find a way to you, Lord Jesus, that he will not just be willing to give items, but Lord, that he will give his life to you, Lord Jesus, that he too can have a part of the salvation plan. Bless it, oh Lord. I pray, God, that you will bless this equipment, Lord, that we have right now. We ask you, Lord, that even as we use it, every person, Lord, that picks it up to use it, Lord Jesus, will be blessed. And we pray, God, that the words that come from this item, Lord, will bring blessing to those who are hearing. Those who listen, salvation will arrive at somebody's doorstep on account of using this item. Bless our Lord. Lead and direct. For we look to thee, O Lord, and we take thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. God bless. God bless. Amen. Okay, praise the Lord. I'm going to say one more thing before you, right? Praise the Lord. It is offering time in the temple. Amen. Praise God. I'd like to ask you to stand at this time as we ask God's blessing on the offering. Amen. Praise God. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love and your grace. And your people are prepared, Lord, to give a gift to this ministry. Lord, put it from the resources that you have blessed them with over this week, the month. Lord, we pray, God, that as your people give, that you will in turn bless them. We pray, Lord, that you will multiply, Lord Jesus, what they have given to do much work. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God, that thou wilt continue to open up windows for them. Every blocked door, Lord, open it up. Every obstacle, every confusion, every entanglement, we pray, God, that you will do a miracle for them just because they give. Have your way, Lord. And remember those who don't have it today to give, Lord. May you bless them in such a way, Lord, that they will happily give. Whenever, Lord Jesus, they have it. Have your way, O Lord, as we look to them and tell you thanks. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Okay, praise the Lord. Amen. All right, and while we happily give our offering, we are going to be blessed by the ministry of Sister Kevina Allen. Please welcome her in Jesus' name.
Shall
we
praise the Lord, everybody? Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's pray to me while I sing this song in Jesus' name. Praise God.
Your only son, no sin to hide, but you have sent him from your side to walk upon this guilty show.
Thank you.
Different, to hear in a different format. And we are blessed in Mount Royal to have wonderful speakers, wonderful men and women of God that God is using in a time like this to expound his word. We have in our midst our assistant pastor, you know, a person like Elder Dwight Reid, a man that is quite humble and one that is as dedicated as you will ever find. One of the most dedicated persons that you will ever find, or man of God that you will ever find in this world. It is with great pleasure, it is my honor today just to bring into this pulpit and to say to God, use it, God. Hallelujah. Use it, Jesus. Hallelujah. He's done it many times before, and we believe that God will continue to use this man of God to bless our hearts. God bless you. God bless you, man of God, as you come. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. All over this building. Let's give him some worship. Give him some worship. Give him some worship. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, you're worthy. You are worthy. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Yeah, he didn't have to do it, but he did. Thank you, Jesus. When we were not interested in him, he was interested in us. Praise God. When we were turning our backs on him, when we were doing our own thing, minding our own business, he had a plan for us. Blessed be the name of our God. Amen. You still want to worship him some more? Oh, hallelujah. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I give honor to the Spirit of God here again, like I said before. And I was going to say thanks be to God that I am able to say something for him. Amen. I just want to give God glory for this opportunity. I have some items written down here before me that I just love to share with you. I am praying that I am not very long today. I've been trying not to do so much exertion. You know, we've been going through some hard times, but that doesn't say that the word of God isn't to be preached. Amen. Or that we aren't to do the work of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Many times we have been through things, but God is still worthy to be praised. Thanks be to God. And I want to draw your attention on just a little topic here. It has to do with unity. Yeah, has to do with unity. Praise God. And I want to firstly draw your attention to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12, where it speaks a little bit about unity. Amen. I know earlier in the book it spoke of spiritual gifts, but don't you know that you can have gifts if you don't have unity, your gifts don't mean nothing? Praise God. You can have gifts and your gifts are used for your own, you know, you're trying to propagate yourself and your image. And if your gifts are used for this, then it would mean nothing. So, in the book of Corinthians chapter 12, Paul spoke of gifts, but then when he was done talking about gifts, he spoke a little bit about unity. Amen. And let me read from verse 12 a little bit here. I might not read the entire thing, but I just want to read it because the chapter itself tells a message, and you can just by reading it get the message. It says, for as the body is one and hath many members, and all the members of that one body being many are one body, so also is Christ. For by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been made all to drink in one Spirit. For the body is one, not many member, but one. For the body is not one member, but many. That's right. If the foot shall say, because I am not the hand, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? And if the ear shall say, because I am not the eye, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? If the whole body were an open eye, where are the hearing? If the whole were hearing, where were the smelling? I'll just stop there. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless this word. Lord Jesus, I pray, God, that something will be said today to enlighten your people and to even enlighten me, Lord, as I try to pass on something to your people. I pray, God, that your word might reach deep, that your word might be able to uproot, Lord, and that your word might be able to replenish. Do your job, though, Lord, as you know best, for I give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, God. When you read the Bible, most of the times, in trying to bring a point out, you'll find that whoever the writer is, they will use a lot of analogies and comparisons and try to relate to the listener the message that they are trying to pass on by using something that they can relate to and understand. Amen. It's a very powerful technique because it allows the speaker or the writer not just to pass on abstract information to whoever is listening, but because of skillfully using the tool of analogies and comparisons, the preacher is able to, in a very powerful way, let the persons actually feel and understand what the main message is all about. So in this case, the analogy being used to bring across the idea of unity is the body. Shall we praise the Lord?
Amen.
The body is used as that item that we can now relate to understand the principle of unity. Shall we praise God? You know, even in hell, there has to be some amount of unity. How many of you know that the devil cannot tolerate indiscipline in his territory? Praise God. Jesus himself said, a kingdom that is divided against itself is going to fall. And the principle is not just for good kingdoms, but for bad kingdoms. Shall we praise the Lord? Unity is a necessary ingredient even in the underworld. Amen. Gangs that are brought together have to be cemented together by some common unity and some purpose. Shall we praise God?
Amen.
Shall we praise God?
Amen.
So unity is important even for the bad guys. So what's it, the church? Shall we praise him?
Amen.
Amen. So since the devil requires unity, the people of God even more so need to be unified. Shall we praise God?
Hallelujah.
Yes, unity is a very important topic that we need to understand before we can move forward. Even as we are now engulfed into what we call a pandemic, amen, that you have different news going out and you have different explanations being thrown out as to why we are where we are. Amen. And how we should deal with the situation that is now up on us. We firstly need, as a church of God, to come together and realize in a unified way that the devil is at work. Shall we praise God? We need to understand that the Bible has already said to us that at the end times, perilous times are going to come upon us. Amen. The Bible has already told us that there are going to be wars, and not just wars, but rumors of wars, pestilence and famine. I know it's not a nice news to hear, praise God, but the Bible says that these things are going to come upon us. And I'm standing here this afternoon and I wish I could say that COVID-19 is the last pandemic or epidemic that is going to meet upon us. I don't think I can say that, because when you look at the escalation of what is happening in the world today, hallelujah, you don't have to think too far to understand that there is a sinister spirit at work that is trying to come up against the church of God. So something else might be lined up to happen, but we just got to be ready. Shall we praise God? And we got to be ready in a unified way. Because the devil is going to try to pull us apart. And when you pull us apart, then he can get in the middle and then his work can be done. He's going to try to pull us apart by letting us quarrel among ourselves about things that really does not matter much. Shall we praise God? He's going to cause us to quarrel among each other about items that are not important, while the important thing goes away. Praise God. We've got to understand the devices of the enemy. Yes, so unity is important. Unity is important. Amen. Praise God. And what a place to speak of unity, what the church in Corinth.
Come on.
Corinth had a history.
Yes.
Corinth had a history of troublemakers. Praise be to God. You try to preach to them something and they take it their own way. There was a time Paul had to explain to them that the increase comes from God, and he should not try to make a difference between himself and Apollos. Yes, Apollos was powerful and he had his work. I am Paul and I have my work laid out before me. Praise be to God. But some persons were trying to create divisions. Some wanted to go Apollos and some wanted to go Paul. So Paul had to straighten them out. Yes, Corinth was a church of trouble.
Yes.
It occupied a very special place in that territory of the time that is called Asia Minor. Merchants traveled from all over the world to bring their wares to Corinth. Praise God. And to trade. So they were going to other big cities, and it was like a transshipment point where they would just stop in Corinth and sell some stuff to make a little money and move on. But actually make a lot of money and move on. Praise God. It was Caesar himself, Julius Caesar, who rebuilt Corinth. And the rebuilding was completed just 50 years before Christ came into the world. Praise God. And it rose to such a place of prominence in the Roman Empire. So in AD 51, Paul came to Corinth. That was like a year, you know, after, you know, that's what, in 51, Paul came to Corinth. He found that the place was populated with prostitutes and entertainers and weird kind of people were roaming the streets. The main place of worship that they knew was the Temple of Diana. And the people participated in all manner of licentious behavior. This was a terrible place. Hallelujah. The Corinthian church was born during Paul's evangelism, as outlined in, but you can find this in Acts chapter 17 and 18, where he spent about 1.5 years to establish. The members of the church in Corinth exhibited the best and the worst. Shall I praise the Lord?
Amen.
The best and the worst of the city could be found exhibited in the Corinthian church. Many of them who came to God or came to the Corinthian church were once drunkards. They were homosexuals. Yeah, it's not a new thing. It's happened in days ago. Long, long, long time. Extortioners, but now they have come into the church and are now calling on the name of Jesus. Shall we praise the Lord? It's very important that when you come to God, you need to flush out a lot of what you had before. Amen. Because if you don't do that, you'll find that it will try to bring itself up and to introduce itself as a trait in the church when it is not right. Shall we praise God? Yes, praise God. So it was filled with these kind of people, and they have now become children of God. Now, with such a mixture, it was inevitable, think about it, that problems would occur. It was a mixture of people. And contrary to what some people think, when you get saved, it's not every time you get a 180 turn. Some people get that, but some people you have to gradually work with them. Are you listening to me? You got to work with them to clear out to what is inside them that is not necessary. Shall we praise God? You have to work with them to purge out some stuff that has been there. Praise God. Somebody said, please be patient with me. God is not true with me yet. Yes, I've come to God and I'm doing my best, but there's some stuff, some residual Corinthian stuff that is stealing me that I need to get rid of. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Praise God. So don't throw the towel on me just yet, because God ain't true with me yet. Praise God. So Paul used a very good analogy to let them understand what he was trying to say. Paul reminded them that their bodies were the temple of the living God. And if they were to overcome the problems that they are now facing, they have got to realize that they have now given over their body to Jesus, because their body is the temple of the living God. Praise God.
Amen.
And that they're going to have to work together. And so you understand why the body is important. Praise God. Many times Jesus describes his church as a body. And you can really understand what he was trying to say. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. My voice was went down. Oh, it's back. Thank you very much, sir. Praise God. You can really understand what God is saying, amen, when you compare yourself to a real body. It is important to note that unity was a concept that Paul was attempting to enforce in the Corinthian church. We find that the word one, listen to me now, the word one was used 27 times, praise God, including 13 times in chapter 12. Paul was trying to get to them a message. He was trying to get across to them a principle. Unity, oneness. It is important. Praise God. So he also used the word together. Together was used 12 times in 1 Corinthians. Surely, praise God. So he's using words to get his message across. Oneness. Togetherness. Surely, praise God.
Amen.
It was necessary for Paul to drill the principle of unity into the minds of the Corinthians, because the enemy had begun to revive the sectarian and social prejudices that they had before they became Christians. Praise God. If the visions were not corrected, the Corinthian church was threatened to be engulfed in the mire of depravity and perversion that pervades the city of Corinth. Praise God. Corinth wasn't a nice place. Like I said before, you had very weird people existing here. You had those that have homosexual tendencies. You have those that were adulterous and they were doing all manner of evil. You had people that were involved in sorcery and praise God. You had the witches and the place was just one big mess. Praise God. And if they did not have unity, Paul was saying to them that they may just go back to where they were before. But the devil is a liar. Can we praise the Lord, everybody? Hallelujah. The word of God says, by one spirit are you all baptized into one body. Whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one spirit. Shall we praise God? Shall we praise the Lord, everybody? Amen. Now you need to understand what a bonded or a free person was in those times. Praise God. Somebody said there was slavery in those days, but it was not exactly slavery. Shall we praise God? There were times in those days that if you owed somebody something, praise God, then by law, if you cannot find what you have owed them with, one part of the deal would be for you to be their slave for a particular time. In other words, you were bonded to them. Shall we praise God? And so that person is going to have control over you, praise God, for a particular time until you would have relieved your debt to him. Shall we praise God? And so the bonded person was in control. Hallelujah. But then there were some people who were not bonded at all, and those were free. Praise God. And so Paul was saying to them that it don't matter what situation you found yourself in, whether you're a bonded slave or you're free, when it comes to the gospel, we have all been made to drink of the one cup. Shall we praise God? Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We have been made to drink in the same spirit. Praise God. So, the purpose of the Spirit of God is to bring us into Christ-likeness. Amen. Praise God. You've always heard me say this, you know, and I continue to say that the Lord is not interested in making us identical. Amen. He's not interested in making me exactly like Brother Colin. Praise God. You know, I just don't know how that would work. I just chance to Brother Colin being me. Amen. I just chance to myself being Brother Colin. He is he and I am me. Praise God. And I don't want to be like him, and certainly I don't think he wants to be like me. Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Because I keep on saying that if two persons are exactly the same and alike, you know how they say this, then one of them is not necessary. Shall we praise the Lord? If you're married to somebody and you said, honey, what about that? And you say, yes, dear. Honey, what about that? Yes, dear. What, you like this color right here? Say, yes, dear. You think my nose is too big? Yes, dear. You like for a walk? Yes, dear. What kind of life is that? Oh my God. Two persons cannot be the same. Don't you like some little variety? Shall we praise God? We have some difference. My God, so it is in the body of Christ. We cannot be the same. Come on, everybody. We cannot be the same. Hallelujah, everybody not going to talk like me. Everyone not going to do the same here, do like me. I've been doing this one for 40 years. You're not going to look like me. Shall we praise God? And I'm telling you to be like me because I am me. Shall we praise God? Oh, almighty God. So we are different, but we have the same purpose. Shall we praise God? We have the same purpose. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. God wants us to be unified. It is important to note that unity was a concept that Paul was attempting to enforce in the Corinthian church. Praise God. The word of God says that we are come together by one spirit. Praise God. That we are brought together in unity by one spirit. Praise God. Paul emphasized the oneness of our common spiritual experience. He speaks of that in Ephesians 4 verse 4. He said, we have one body, one spirit, one hope, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. Shall we praise God? I don't know, but we have got to start to live together. Praise God. When the world is coming up against us and we have pandemics and all kind of things waiting at the doorstep, we have better start to live together. Praise God, because you can't do it by yourself. I can't do it by myself. You cannot stay in your corner and do it by yourself. But together, we are a mighty army. Come on, give God a praise. Hallelujah. A mighty army, mighty army. Praise God. Let's look at one hope. Hope is vital for human contentment. Without hope, people are miserable. Praise God. The Bible tells you that. Praise God. Without hope, we are miserable. Praise God. Now, the Greek word for hope is elpis, meaning to anticipate, expectation, or confidence. To have hope is to have confident expectation. Shall we praise God? Amen. And I look up, Lord, it says we need to have one Lord. Some of the people evangelized by apostles held strange religious beliefs of gods who would bring them different benefits. Whether it be the god Zeus, the god Hermes, the god Diana, or even Caesar himself, who was regarded as a god. Praise God. Paul showed the Corinthians that there is one God that unifies us. A God in whom we can get whatever we need from him. Praise God. Can you see the unity? Shall we praise God? Praise God. Can you see the unity? Praise God. Now, I said earlier that Paul used an example of the body. And if you think of the body is a remarkable creation. Think about it. It is certainly a remarkable creation. It is the crowning creation of God's work. Hallelujah. When God finished made man, look at that, he said it was good. Praise God. Praise God. It was very good. Shall we praise God? And if you think of it, the body is totally a remarkable creation. The Bible says that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. God put something into your creation. Hallelujah. Don't go quarreling about how you look, about your color and the size of your feet. God put some thought into why you are who you are. Come on, everybody. Praise God. God designed you exactly how you wanted to be designed. I can never understand why it is that people grow up and let people tell them that you are too black, or people tell them that you are too white, or people tell them that your nose too big. When God made them that way, God made me this way. This is how I want to be. Come on, praise God. Fearfully and wonderfully made. You are not a mistake. Every cell that, hallelujah, every cell that God used to make you what you are, God thought about it. Hallelujah. Every blood that ran in your vein, God thought about it. You are not a mistake. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, God. No man made creation to measure up to the creation of God. Hallelujah. How complicated is the human body? Praise God. How complicated God made us. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Not even the doctors understand the magnificence of the creation of God body. Don't even know that in the hospital the medicine is created, that for the most part, what medicines do is to cause your body to recognize what is happening to it, and it is actually your body that does the fighting. Don't you know that? Praise God. Even right now, they can't even find a cure for COVID. So what they are trying to do is to fortify your body so the body will build up a resistance and does the fight for you. Praise God. It's not the medicine, it's the fight in the body. My God, whenever you feel a fever, it is not the doctor of the fever wants to be a fever. It is because the mechanisms that are in your body are coming together to fight what is coming against the body. You are wonderfully and fearfully made. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes. Praise God. And so the body is a very wonderful thing. And as a physical body, hath many members, so does the church. Praise God. In verse 28, if you should go down there, it says, Paul said, God hath set some in the church, first apostles, secondary the prophets, third the teachers, praise God. And he said also in verse 26, and whether one member suffer, all the members suffer with it. And one member being honored, all the members with it. I wish we would reach a stage, praise God, that we would start to celebrate somebody's blessing. That we don't envy somebody's blessing. Praise God. If we are one body, why do we want to dismiss somebody when God blesses them? Or why do we rejoice when somebody is hurt? Why? Oh my God. We are one body. So it's got to start celebrating each other. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So the Corinthian church, my brethren, had to deal with diversity of Christians and their behavior because of where they were coming from. Praise God. So what was the behavior that Paul still was compelled to bring them together rather than to ostracize them? He had to bring them together. They were different, but he had to do a work. He had to bring them together. Yes. All of these people, all of the warlock had to work with the former prostitute, had to work with the former the Jew or the Sadducee or whatever. Praise God, they had to come together. The thief had to work with the innocent, and praise God, the doctor had to work with the lawyer. Everybody have to come together. They have to start to put aside some things and look for the unifying force that binds them together. Praise God. So Paul had a job.
Come on, sir.
Praise God. Paul had a job because he realized that the pain of one became the pain of all. The joy of one became the joy of all. Praise God. Praise God. When you look at the fee for transportation, has to take the hard hits. Think about it. The fee has to take all the hard hits. Praise God. The feet is stepped upon. It sometimes steps in mud. Sometimes steps in you know what. But that is the duty of the feet. Oh my God. Nobody else wants to do that job. Nobody else in the body wants to do that job because they were designed for that. And that's the duty of the feet. Praise God. So when the feet don't go back to the feet, you have to say, thank God for my feet. Praise God. When I look at the hands are used for almost all other outside activities. The hand. That is why the apostle did not talk about the gift of laying of feet. You heard that one before? The Bible did not speak about the gift of laying of feet. In the laying of hands, I don't know, maybe I can see some manifestations where the Lord used your feet to align someone. I have never seen that before. I never seen that before. Laying of feet. I don't know about that gift, but I know about the one that says laying of hands. Surely praise God. You see that there are members of your body that are built for a specific reasons. Thanks be to God. And as we go into the spirit, we have to think about unity. Let us think about it. Praise God. I won't go through all the other things because you know very well how difficult it can be and how important some parts of the body is. I need to tell a story. I hope you don't laugh. I like to say it in Sunday school about situation, somebody was using an example how they were disparaging certain parts of the body. It was like a story, disparaging certain parts of the body. And then certain parts of the body were there telling how good they are, the hand was saying, well, you know, I do this and I can pick up things, and you know, well, and the eye was saying, well, you can't pick up things if you don't see it. And then the nose was boasting about how the nose would be able to smell and do all manner of things, And then, just as the bottom was about to say what it did, the president said, "No, you shut up." And the bottom said, "All right, I'll shut up." Hmm? And it was then they realized how important the duties of the bottom was. Because with all that goes on down there, you think that that's not so important, you know. Until time reach, you have to acknowledge. I want to tell you, it happens in the church, you know. Thank you, Jesus. It happens in the church when we start to think that we better than somebody else. When we start to elevate ourselves about other people because of what we do. Oh, mighty God, and you feel like you can talk to anybody or you want to talk because God has elevated you to this position. Look at me. I'm a minister and I preach. You must have respect for me. Praise God. You must do what you should because I demand respect for my position. Yes, it's happening, church. Mighty God of Daniel, it is time that we begin to see that we are all together in this thing. Praise be to God, the job that I do, you can't do, the job that you do, I can't do, but God is one. I want to talk to somebody today who's moving into the direction of the Corinthians. Is moving into the direction where they think that your place and your position matters. I want to let you know that in the church of God, only one person matters, and that is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Give me Jesus in the morning. Give me Jesus at noonday. Give me Jesus in the evening. He's the reason why I live. He's the reason why I'm here today. It's not about the elder. It's not about the pastor, the bishop. It's not about the apostle. It is all about Jesus. Give me Jesus every time. Put aside the differences and the bigotry and give me Jesus. And when we begin to reduce ourselves, then we begin to understand what the purpose of our mission is. It is not to sell and grandize ourselves. It is not to put ourselves on a pedestal. It's all about Jesus. And him through the fire. Praise God. I'm better to be a beast in the work of God and to be elevated into the house of the wicked. It's all about Jesus. Praise God. You never know when you're going to need the help of a member of the body that you begin to beat down. You never know that you're going to need the help of somebody that you continue to castigate. You never know when you're going to need the help of somebody who you think you continue to ostracize. With God, there is no division of persons. We are all nothing before the presence of God. Hallelujah. Don't put yourself higher on your heart to be where all instruments in the hand of God. Praise God. Let us start to give more recognition to the perceived less members of the body.
Amen.
In this church, everybody matters. Everybody means something.
Yes, come on.
You have a part to play in the kingdom of God. I can't do your work, and you can't do my work. Let us come together, saints of God, and realize our position. Let us come together and recognize our mission. Keep our eyes on the prize. And don't be distracted by the ways of the Corinthians. Keep our eyes on the prize, and we will know what it is that God wants us to do. And the body will be a healthy body. where everybody functions, where everybody does what it is supposed to do, and the name of our God is glorified. Thank you for listening today. And if you're listening to us by Facebook, or you're viewing us by our YouTube channel, this message is for you too. Our God is a fear God. Amen. And each one of us was made for a specific purpose. So you're there listening to me, and somebody might be beating you down. Somebody might have been trying to make you feel like a nothing. The devil is a liar. You are something, and there is work in the kingdom for you. Continue to listen, but better still, make a commitment to God that you will serve him. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Wherever in the body you fall, you are necessary, and we want you to be a part of the family of God. God bless you today as we contemplate these words in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for the word. Praise God. Thank you for using Elder Reid to minister to us today. It doesn't matter how small or how big you are, we are all important in the house of God. Praise God.
I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from every fear. Those who look on him are radiant, they'll never be ashamed, they'll never be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard.